Hello, my name is Sara Garces, and along with my colleague Hugo Gomes, we will present some results about archaeometric characterization and production techniques in rock art pigments. Let me start by introducing ourselves. Hugo is a geologist and did his PhD in archaeometry of rock art pigments, and I am an archaeologist and I did my PhD in prehistoric rock art of Portugal. We work together under the scientific guidance of Professor Pierluigi Rossina and in strong collaboration with Dr. Hipólito Collado from Spain. Our main partner institutions are the Polytechnic Institute of Tomar, the Geoscience Center of University of Coimbra, the Instituto Terra e Memoria in Maçã, Portugal, and the University of Ferrara in Italy. Our archaeometric analysis project is a continuation of a project that started in 2010 and was part of a much wider research program called Hoop Science. In the beginning of this project, prehistoric pigments and natural ochre samples were extracted from a group of open-air rock art sites from Portugal and Spain. The different technological approaches recognized for each site required a variety of different laboratory strategies. Based on our research, the technological processes applied were essential in order to determine which materials were used in pigment recipes. Archaeometric analysis explores the chemical and mineral qualities of sampled pigments and is considered a very important methodology within rock art studies. This research aims to establish a methodological approach for the chemical and mineralogical characterization of rock art paintings and to raise questions on the preparation, production, and even conservation of prehistoric pigments. Why? Because we are interested in finding which processes are involved in the production of prehistoric paintings and if any organic material were being applied to the pigments as well. This information is very important to better understand the symbolic features and behaviors that past societies were performing in specific moments of their lives. Pigments or dye for painting is produced using an array of mined or quarried organic and inorganic substances. The majority of pigments identified within prehistoric rock art are made with iron oxides and hydroxides, originally from hematite and goethite. The main sources of these oxides are the so-called ochres, colored in shades of red and yellow. As coloring agents, natural iron oxide pigments have served modern and archaic hominids for at least 150,000 years. Despite the fragmentary archaeological record, their use was associated with the production of funerary ritual activity, personal cosmetic use, body decoration, and rock art. On Group Science project, the rock paintings studied were selected from rock art shelters that are considered to be part of the schematic rock art tradition, an artistic style that is, archaeologically speaking, relatively common in the Iberian Peninsula, extending chronologically from the early Neolithic to the end of the Bronze Age. Motifs are distinct and are organized into three main typological groups: anthropomorphic, zoomorphic figures, and geometric figures. Those are considered non-representative motifs. The schematic rock art is found in numerous locations throughout the Iberian Peninsula. Many regional complexes are described by researchers. Any direct dating of these painting sites is considered very difficult, owing to the absence of organic material for direct chronometric dating. We also developed research on rock art sites from Ethiopia, Brazil, Angola, and the UK. It is important to make analysis in different archaeological contexts in order to validate our results. A direct date cannot be obtained on rock art that is made with inorganic pigments. However, some studies have clearly shown that pigments were produced using recipes that involve the use of organic binders. Painting is an adhesive technique where it is applied to a natural rock surface. The coloring agent, a fluid or semi-fluid pigment, is usually applied directly to the rock surface. This technique requires a complex process that begins with the selection and supply of raw materials, followed by the preparation of the pigment, the choice of tools to use in the application, and the execution technique. Analyses have shown that pigments found in a variety of riparian locations used mineral oxides known as hematite as main material. Generally, these and other minerals would have origin in nearby sources. Sampling is a very important action because it has to be done with careful not to damage the painted panel. All researchers before making a project on sampling rock art have to be aware of the objectives of the sampling because it is considered a damage process to the paintings, and the reason to do so has to be linked to a very important scientific question that requires sampling to be answered. Pigment samples must be collected in strategic figurative representations in order to encompass all the different typologies of the painted figures. It is also taken into account the color variations of figures, various shades of red, for example, substratum and concretions, using non-contact ethical extraction techniques, applying the code of ethics and guidelines for the practice of American Institute for Conservation. Each sample must be obtained using a sterilized tungsten scalpel and inserted in a microcentrifuge tube. Our team usually does the sampling scheme of the site so that the information reaches the colleagues in the laboratory in a clear and organized way. The components of pigments identified through archaeometric characterization analysis reveal the homogeneity of the raw materials used in pigment production, but different preparation and application techniques are also recognized. The results established that the raw materials used in the reddish pigments in the schematic art of the Western Iberian Peninsula were essentially iron oxides and hydroxides, hematite and goethite in particular, based on the laboratory works on preparation techniques such as grinding and likely thermal heating of the pigment were also commonly identified. This could be associated with binder substance and/or binding agents. The most used methods to make a characterization in prehistoric pigments are micro-Raman spectroscopy. With this method, we can better determine the mineralogical composition of pigment samples, production processes, chemical reactions, and degradation processes. The energy dispersive X-ray microfluorescence. With this method, we can make a multi-element analysis. Scanning electron microscopy. With SEM, we can make a morphological observation of organic and inorganic materials. Fourier transform infrared spectroscopy, FATIR, which gives us an elemental composition of the sample, organic material included, and increases the sensitivity of the analysis. Gas chromatography, which is used to identify organic components. Microstratigraphy is very useful to observe the positioning of the main components, the rock substrate of the base, the pictorial layers covered by concretions. Although the characterization of inorganic pigments is relatively well developed all over the world, identifying and characterizing binders in prehistoric pigments is still extremely difficult due to the aging and quality of the sample, the type of material used and its reaction to degradation. Because they are of organic origin, they are very difficult to identify, and only a few techniques used in the characterization of pigments will be optimized for their identification and characterization, although these have to be complemented with other techniques. Our research has already been able to identify organic materials in several samples from the Iberian Peninsula, Ethiopia and Brazil, which make us very enthusiastic about the application of this program of various methodologies for a better approach to the symbolic behavior of past societies.